Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So in this video, I will be presenting another diode circuit known as voltage regulator. So a voltage regulator circuit is constructed using a specific diode known as the Zener diode. So I think it will be better if I give some introduction about the Zener diode, yeah? So a Zener diode operates in a breakdown region. So what happens during this breakdown region? Okay. So basically, what happens is that when you provide a reverse bias voltage here, okay, and if you keep on increasing this reverse bias voltage, you are going to increase the total electric field inside the depletion region. So it will come to a point where the electric field inside this depletion region may be large enough for the covalent bond to break. It will create a new electron hole pairs. So the total electric field will be in the direction from N to P. So the force on holes will be in this direction, and the force on electrons will be the opposite direction. Okay? So there is also newly created electron hole pairs in the N type region. So the holes in your N type will see this force. Therefore, it will be accelerated to go to your P type and complete the circuit. And similarly, the electrons generated in your P-type will see this force. So, the electrons are attracted to go through this depletion region and also complete the circuit. So, there will be a current when this happens. Therefore, the movement of these newly created carriers is the one referred to as the Zener effect. Okay? So, you can see here in this slide, the Zener effect occurs in the reverse bias region. So you can see here the voltage is constant for a range of currents. So this is the range of current that can operate within this specified breakdown voltage. And this characteristic allows for diodes to be fabricated with this specifically designed voltage value. So this is known as Zener diodes. So the circuit symbol for a Zener diode is as follows. So you can see here the voltage applied here is reverse bias. The positive terminal is provided at the N type, okay, and the negative terminal is provided at this triangle symbol. But this value is constant because it is fabricated with a specified breakdown voltage, and the current will go in the reverse bias direction, and it is denoted as IZ. Okay, so this slide is showing the difference between a standard PN junction diode and a Zener diode. So you can see the symbol also is different. You can see this Z symbol here, and this is just a straight line. But the most important difference that I would like to highlight is this property where Zener diode can function in both conditions. So both directions basically. So what happened is that when your Zener diode is forward biased, it will act like a standard PN junction diode. So if your Zener diode is forward biased, you just need to represent it according to the model in the question, whether it is ideal model, model 2 or model 3. However, when it is reverse biased, it will take the value of VZ just like this, which means that the voltage is constant. So it is because of this unique property that Zener diode is used in the voltage regulator circuit, because it can provide a constant voltage within a range of current. So this is the inventor of Zener diode. So you can see here it is named after him. So in my opinion, he's quite handsome. So now let us look at the application of Zener diode in a voltage regulator circuit. So a voltage regulator supplies constant voltage to a load. So this is your voltage regulator. So the voltage across your load will be a constant value. So this is the circuit of a voltage regulator. So you can see that the Zener diode is placed here and it is connected in parallel with the load resistor. So you can see the Zener diode is reverse bias because the power supply will generate a current in this direction as shown here, and once it reaches node A, it will split creating IZ and IL. So you can see IZ is in the reverse bias direction, and therefore your Zener diode will take the value of VZ. So that's why it says here the Zener diode holds the voltage constant regardless of the current Isaac. Okay, so the load resistors now will see a constant voltage because they are connected in parallel. The rest of the power supply voltage will be across the input resistor RI. So there are four things that you need to remember when you are dealing with voltage regulator. The first one is, in order to operate, a Zener diode requires a minimum current. So you can see it requires Isaac min to operate. So of course there is a maximum current that it can operate, which is Isaac max. So basically the power supply must be high enough to at least provide Isaac min to your Zener diode. Secondly, is you must always take note that the voltage across your load will always equal to VZAC because they are connected in parallel as shown here. Next, using KCL at node A here, the main current Iin is equivalent to Isaac plus IL, and then the voltage across the input resistor RI will be equivalent to the voltage supply minus VZAC. So if we want to calculate Iin, you can use Ohm's law, which is VRI over RI. So let's do one example. A Zener diode is connected in a voltage regulator circuit and you are given the power supply to be 20 volt and the Zener voltage is 10 volt. Input resistor is 222 ohm and the Zener diode power rating is 400 milliwatt. You can see here, it gives you PZAC max, which means that when your VZAC multiply with IZAC max, you will get this value, the PZAC max. So the question would like to know the values of the load current, the Zener diode current, and the main current if the load resistor is 380 ohm. And then secondly, you are asked to calculate RL if the Zener diode is operating at its maximum rating, which means that the current flowing through your Zener diode is Isaac max. So this is what the question wants you to solve. So I'm going to show this using the whiteboard.
A few moments later.
So this is the voltage regulator in your example. And you are given the RI is 222 ohm. VPS is 20 volt. And VZ is 10 volt. So this is your I input, your IZ and your IL. So the question asks for two things. The first one is, what are these three currents when RL equivalent to 380 ohm? So based on the notes that I have highlighted, the first one is, we just assume that this VPS is large enough to create IZ min, okay? Secondly, your VZ will always equivalent to VL because they are connected in parallel. So your VZ is equivalent to VL, which is 10 volt. And KCL, Iin equivalent to IZ plus IL. And VRI equivalent to VPS minus VZ. Okay? So these are the important notes for this voltage regulator. Okay? So the first part of the question is asking these three currents. So based on this information, you can actually calculate IL. So you can calculate IL using Ohm's law. Okay? Because IL equivalent to VL over RL and we know that VL equivalent to 10 volt. So now you have the value of IL. Okay. So based on this second point, Iin equivalent to IZ plus IL. So we already calculated IL, but we still don't know what is Isaac, and we still don't know what is Iin. However, this third point can be utilized to calculate Iin. So based on this third point, VRI is equivalent to 20 minus 10, which is 10 volt. So this information allows us to use Ohm's law to calculate Iin using VRI over RI, and you can get Iin. Okay, so I'm going to wipe this off so that we can solve it using all this information. So, remember the first one, we can calculate IL using VL over RL. And based on the first information, VL equivalent to VZ and given RL equivalent to 380 ohm. So, 10 over 380 ohm equivalent to 0.026 ampere.
Next is the VRI equivalent to 20 minus 10, which is 10 volt. And therefore, you can use Ohm's law to calculate Iin, which is VRI over RI. And you already obtained VRI 10 over 222, and you will get 0.045 ampere. So now you know what is IL and Iin. You can use the KCL equation, Iin equivalent to Iz plus IL, and you can calculate Iz. Therefore, Iz equivalent to 0.045 minus 0.028, which is equivalent to 0.017 ampere. So these are the answers for the three currents. So the second part of the question is asking what is the value of RL that will establish PZ max in your Zener diode. So I'm going to wipe this off again and draw the voltage regulator circuit. So now in the second part of the question, you want to find what is RL. The other information are the same. You still have the same power supply, same value of RI, and VZ is still 10 volt. Okay? But the current flowing through your VZ is IZ max. But the main current Iin is still the same. Because the voltage across your RI, which is VRI, is still equivalent to VPS minus VZ, equivalent to 10 volt. So Iin is still the same, at which the value is 0.045 ampere. We have calculated in the first part just now. Alright? However, now, this main current will split and Iz flowing through your Zener diode will be Iz max. Okay? So what do you need to do? You need to find what is your IL now, because IL will be different. So tell me, what would you do? You got the answer? Never mind. So based on the first point, remember the first point, Vz equivalent to Vl? So this one will always be 10 volts. So this is the property of voltage regulator. It will keep on maintaining the voltage despite whatever current flowing through the load. So this is the unique characteristic of your voltage regulator. Therefore, Vl is still 10 volt, but we want to know what is IL. So back to the KCL equation, Iin equivalent to Iz max plus IL. So we know that Iin equivalent to 0.045 equivalent to Iz max plus IL, right? So we need to know what is IL in order to find what is RL, because once you know IL, you can use Ohm's law to get RL, which is VL over IL. So the only way to find IL is based on this equation. Now, we need to find Iz max. What information is given to you in the question? Pz max. You need to use Pz max. Okay? So I'm going to wipe this off and let's solve this part of the question. Pz max is equal to 400 milliwatt, which is equivalent to Vz multiplied with Iz max. So this is 400 milliwatt equivalent to 10 multiplied with Iz max. Therefore, Iz max equivalent to 40 milliampere or 0.040 ampere. Okay, remember the KCL equation? So now I can find IL equivalent to Iin minus Iz max. So I have 0.005 ampere. So this is my IL that I will use to calculate RL, okay, which is equivalent to VL over IL. So 10 over 0.005 ampere. So the answer for the new RL that will establish PZ max is, so it's 2000 ohm or 2 kilo ohm. Okay? So that is the solution for this example. So, Assalamualaikum. Bye.